come to me, all you who labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest, says the Lord. Welcome to this funeral service where we gather to pray for the soul of Yvonne Williams, a much loved mother, grandmother, and a friend to all who knew her. On behalf of all the Christians at St. Joseph's Upton, I'd like to bring our sincere condolences to her children, family, relations, and friends who have come to commend her immortal soul to the love and mercy of God, our loving Father. We will now sing our opening hymn, I, the Lord of Sea and Sky.
Speak my words to them,
whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord, it is I, Lord. I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, wind and flame. I will send the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them. My hand will save. Finest wheat I will provide till your hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. It is I, Lord. I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Yvonne, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all the peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil, covering all peoples, and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth, for the Lord said so. That day it will be said, "See, this is our God, in whom we hope for salvation. The Lord is one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that you saved us all." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Psalm 22, the response is, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want." Response, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near as full waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit." Response, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He guides me along the right path, he is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff, with these you give me comfort. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil, my cup is overflowing. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. We'll now sing the hymn, Make Me a Channel of Your Peace. Let us stand for the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. It is my Father's will, says the Lord, that whoever believes in the Son shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up on the last day. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, seeing the crowd, Jesus went up the hill. There he sat down and was joined by his disciples. Then he began to speak. This is what he taught them. How happy are the poor in spirit, theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Happy the gentle, they shall have the earth for their heritage. Happy those who mourn, they shall be comforted. Happy those who hunger and thirst for what is right, they shall be satisfied. Happy the merciful, they shall have mercy shown them. Happy the pure in heart, they shall see God. Happy the peacemakers, they shall be called sons of God. Happy those who are persecuted in the cause of right, theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Happy are you when people abuse you and persecute you and speak all kinds of calumny against you on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. I'd like to thank Vicky and Mark for helping me to arrange the order of service for their mom, Yvonne. I did not know her personally, but the notes they sent me gave me an insight into who she was. Yvonne was a family person, a happy mother and grandmother who was proud of her children. She did her best to provide for their needs, ignoring the limitations her ill health gave her. She had a determined outlook on life. She did not feel sorry for herself, but carried on with the job of providing for her family. Yvonne was loyal and reliable to her friends. She was charitable and shared her resources as much as possible with those in need, especially in her donations to the Southport Kidney Fund. Many Christians seem to think that it is enough to confess Christ in church on Sunday, but this is not enough. It is out there in the world, a world that is indifferent, skeptical, and sometimes hostile, that we have to witness. It is in the middle of the marketplace that we have to stand up and be counted. It is not good enough to be secret disciples of Christ. We have to give public witness to Christ's love and truth. Today we are sad, of course, but not bitter. How could we be for someone who generated and surrounded us with so much love while she was with us? For someone who fought the good fight and gave us hope, how could we? So we don't have to be heavy-hearted. As Christians, we believe that when we approach the horizon of life that we call death, we do not go into a dark unknown, but into the light of the love of God's house. We will be known and recognized by Christ as his followers and surrounded by a cloud of witnesses, the saints who loved us while they were with us, and now they will love us again. Without love, the world would be a very bleak place. Hence, we should not be surprised to find that love occupies the central place in the gospel of Christ. Christ said that his followers would be recognized by the love they showed towards one another. He went on even further to say that they would be judged on love. St. John of the Cross echoed the words of Christ when he said, "In the evening of life, we shall be examined on love." To those who are sensitive to the needs of others, life offers innumerable opportunities to practice Christ's commandment of love. It is not a question of doing or giving big things. Rather, it is a question of giving oneself a little in little ways, of one's energy, of one's time and love. Real love requires patience. It seeks nothing at all except the good of the other person. To love means to share the burden of others. Yvonne has shown us what love is and how we can practice it in ordinary, everyday ways. We pray that the Lord will forgive Yvonne all her failings in this life, and that she will be happy forever with all the saints in heaven. We'll now have some bidding prayers.
We pray that Yvonne, who in baptism was made a daughter of God, may now rest and rejoice in God's kingdom of life and love. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray that the memories of Yvonne help her family and friends to overcome their grief with gratitude for the gift she has been to them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that our relatives and friends who have gone before us in faith may enjoy unending light and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that those who cared for Yvonne be blessed for their efforts and their service to others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Please join us as we say, Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Thank you very much. We will now listen to the family eulogy.
Today is a bittersweet occasion, as we mourn Yvonne's passing, yet at the same time celebrate her life. We do so on what would have been her 69th birthday. On the 11th of October 1953, Yvonne was the first of three children, born to the late Jackie and Moira Conway. Fun and laughter was always aplenty when Yvonne was growing up, and her gentle nature shone through from a young age. Her mum, Moira, would often be found hoovering the front room, stood in front of Yvonne, stopping her from watching the TV. Unlike her siblings, Greg and Sheila, who would have simply just shouted, "Move, Mum," Yvonne quietly hopped from the sofa to the chair, only to find her mum once again standing in front of her, chuckling as she knowingly obscured her view of the television. On her 18th birthday, as was tradition, Jackie and Moira took Yvonne to the local pub to officially buy her first alcoholic drink. When the landlord came over and asked Jackie if Yvonne was his daughter, his face was filled with joy, and his smile beamed from ear to ear as he confirmed Yvonne was indeed his daughter, who had just turned 18 that day. We can't quite be sure just how Jackie felt when the landlord, having only just set eyes on Yvonne, offered her a job as a barmaid there and then. But it's safe to say that Yvonne, or more likely Moira, talked him round, and their mutual pride was felt once again when Yvonne won the Beautiful Barmaid of the Year competition a short time after. It wasn't just the voters who recognised Yvonne's beauty. Whenever complimenting others within the family or friends, Yvonne's parents would always claim, "Oh, you look just like Yvonne," much to the irritation of her younger sister, Sheila. At the age of 24, Yvonne gave birth to her first child, Vicky. From a young age, Vicky would regularly spend time with her nan and granddad, and just before turning four, Yvonne and Vicky moved back home permanently with Jackie and Moira. Vicky recalls happy memories of her and Yvonne visiting Blockbuster to get films and stopping by the shop for some goodies before returning home and snuggling up to watch films together. Vicky and latterly Mark were always in awe of how Yvonne would quickly identify the plot of the film, and still to this day believe their mum missed her true calling as a scriptwriter. Had Yvonne not made it as a scriptwriter, it's likely a teacher could have been an alternate profession. Yvonne's nephew Craig regularly recalls how Yvonne's stern tone would leave him and the rest of the kids in the neighbourhood reduced to quivering wrecks, a trait her daughter Vicky has certainly inherited. At the age of 36, Yvonne gave birth to her second child, her son Mark. It's safe to say that Mark was the apple of Yvonne's eye, although she did recall the time when Mark was barely three and exclaimed, "Bloody hell," in front of friends. A little embarrassed, Yvonne politely corrected Mark, only to get the response, "Oh, it's okay, Mum. I didn't say bar steward." Obviously cannot say the correct words being spoken there, given we're in the house of God. Yvonne was always proud of Mark throughout his school years and was so pleased that his first job was to work at Woolworths alongside her, enabling her to share a key step in his life with him. Although saddened when they were both made redundant, Yvonne certainly liked the perks of the M&S discount and free cinema tickets available from his subsequent new jobs. She certainly shared many fond memories of going to the cinema with her son. Sadly, not everything in Yvonne's life was smiles and laughter. As many of you know, she suffered poor health for a large part of her life. Her kidney failure started shortly after the birth of her third child, Richard. Unfortunately, Richard did not survive his birth, something Yvonne struggled with. Remembrance Sunday was a symbolic time of year when Richard died. As tribute to him, there is a crocheted poppy being buried with Yvonne that she carried around with her. Yvonne was on the committee of the Southport Kidney Fund, a charity that was very close to her heart due to her kidney failure, something which resulted in her requiring a transplant from her daughter Vicky. Luckily, the transplant was a success, and amazingly, the kidney lasted over 21 years. During these difficult years, the Southport Kidney Fund supported her greatly, and Yvonne, being the caring person that she was, always wanted to give back. With this in mind, anybody wishing to make a donation is politely asked to donate to the Southport Kidney Fund. Yvonne loved spending time with her family whenever she had the opportunity. Christmas gatherings were a favourite, when all her nephews, nieces, and children would get together to celebrate. Yvonne was blessed with a handsome young grandson, Joshua, and three beautiful granddaughters. Firstly, Phoebe, who uncannily looks like her nanny Yvonne, followed by the comical Emily, and the very cute Lottie. Yvonne cherished days out with her grandchildren and made many memories. She only spoke with pride and joy when talking about them, and I'm sure she will continue to look down on them and her unborn grandchild with that same pride and joy. Yvonne successfully battled against breast and ovarian cancer, undergoing life-changing operations in the process. And regrettably, in June 2019, Yvonne's health issues continued, and she suffered a life-changing stroke that would leave her paralysed down her left side. Yvonne's bravery and zest for life meant that she never gave up, even when the odds were stacked against her. The challenges ahead were immense, yet somehow she still smiled and managed to push through. Testament to her strength and resilience was how she battled to recover from the stroke to make sure that it was able to make Mark and Gemma's wedding, having shortly spent a 3-month stint in hospital. The pride on her face that day was clear for all to see. The stroke left Yvonne suffering from dysphagia, which affected her speech. Though personally, I do wonder if she was playing on it, because whenever she swore at me, it was said perfectly and executed with such great passion and conviction. Part of the following few years were spent in lockdown, which was a tough time for us all. However, this only made Yvonne more determined to enjoy herself once things started to get back to normal. Luckily, restrictions were lifted shortly before her newest grandchild, Lottie, was born. Mark recalls her beaming smile the first time she met Lottie. And even with one arm, Yvonne was still able to cradle her much better than him. Despite all these setbacks, Yvonne found a new lease of life when she received her motorised wheelchair and would regularly enjoy days out with Vicky, Mark and her grandchildren. Phoebe recalls the time her nanny had gone out in a motorised chair for the first time. Her sister Emily was beeping the horn and increasing the speed of the chair. Just recap. Yvonne's gone out on a chair for the first time. And so, Emily's beeping the horn and increasing the speed of the chair. And as they're approaching the promenade, Yvonne, who it's worth pointing out had never driven before, approached a turn at some speed, narrowly missing the wall, leaving both Phoebe and Emily on the floor in hysterics. Such pandemonium was only made funnier by Vicky having to run alongside Yvonne to slow her down. This resulted in Yvonne laughing uncontrollably, a sound we were all too familiar with, and we all already sorely miss. On the 25th of September, Yvonne passed peacefully, surrounded by her loving family. In the days that followed, Vicky and Mark took huge comfort in the outpouring of grief and love shown by those here today, as well as those who couldn't be here, such as the extended family in Ireland and Canada. I don't really think Vicky or Mark realised just how many people loved. I don't really think Vicky or Mark realised just how many people love the extraordinary, caring, loving woman we all know as Yvonne. It's only six words. The caring, loving woman that we all know as Yvonne, but they have the privilege to call mum. Come.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our sister in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestow upon Yvonne in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we'll all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May saints and angels lead you on, escorting you where Christ has gone. Now he has called you, come to him who sits above the seraphim. Come to the peace of Abraham and to the supper of the Lamb. Come to the glory of the blessed and to perpetual light and rest. We will now sing our final hymn, Give Me Joy in My Heart. Give me joy in my heart, keep me praying. Give me joy in my heart, I pray. Give me joy in my heart, keep me praising. Keep me praising till the break of day. Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna to the King of Kings. Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna to the King. Give me peace in my heart, keep me praying. Give me peace in my heart, I pray. Give me peace in my heart, keep me praying. Keep me praying till the end of days. Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna to the King of Kings. Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna.